little loud standing under the falls here, but I just used a pretty unique technique where I got a shot of Tommy. I set up my tripod right here, and I got a shot of Tommy walking out in front of the falls, and then I got just a shot, a clean plate, without anyone in it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna blend all the frames of the clean plate together so it basically looks like a long exposure photo, and you can still see the water moving. And then I'm gonna composite Tommy into that so you can see him walking out in front of it with a long exposure behind him. Really unique effect. I think it'll look really cool in the edit.
Look at this quarantine here. It's getting very out of control at this point. So you're gonna get hat Aidin today for the tutorial. I've also got my window open just so we can kind of feel a bit of the outside in this video, even if we can't go there, but it's a bit of a cloudy day, so lighting might be shifting throughout the video, but I think it's a compromise that's worth it to feel a little bit of the outside world right now. As me from the Pacific Northwest, like 3, maybe 4 months ago told you, today I want to show you how I created this long exposure video effect. It's a really cool, trippy effect that I haven't ever seen used in a video before. Obviously, long exposure photos are pretty popular where you're shooting like a waterfall or something and you slow down your shutter so you get that smooth, silky water. But today we're gonna create the exact same effect in a video. First things first, it is so important to this effect that you shoot the right way. You have to get a tripod shot completely locked off and roll for a long enough time. Like I do 30 seconds just to make sure I have enough footage to work with in post. Also, shoot the frame rate that your final video is going to be. Don't shoot slow motion for this effect. There's just no reason to, and it's gonna make the effect less smooth in the end. So my project is gonna be 24 frames per second when it's exported. So instead of shooting 60 frames a second, I'm gonna shoot 24. That's just gonna make the effect a little smoother. It's also important to follow the 180 degree shutter rule for this effect, where your shutter speed is double your frame rate. So since I'm shooting in 24 frames per second, I'm gonna use a shutter speed of 1/50th of a second. That's just gonna make the effect a little smoother in the end because we're already getting the right amount of motion blur in the shot, as opposed to having like perfectly crystal clear, choppy water. I am gonna show you a plugin at the end of this video that you can use as a shortcut that might work in some cases, but first let's go through After Effects and show you the technique that definitely will. So here I've got my shot in After Effects, and what I'm gonna do to start is duplicate the layer and drag it forward one frame. And then you're gonna do that 99 more times so that you have a total of 101 layers, each one frame further into the timeline than the last. I'm not kidding. Then you're gonna select every layer in the composition except for the bottom layer, hit T on your keyboard and set the opacity to 5%. Now it seems like since we have 100 layers and we wanna blend them all together, that 1% opacity would be the right value to set for that, but I've found that that doesn't look right at all, and 5% is actually kind of the sweet spot here. 100 layers, each at 5% opacity, and it looks perfectly smooth. If you set it to 4% opacity or you only do 50 layers, it just starts to get choppier and choppier. And that's pretty much the effect. You can see from using this technique, we have this effect where it kind of animates on over 4 seconds. If you don't want to do that, then you can drag the layers so that you don't have them all gradually fading into the timeline. But I tend to think that extra layer of having it kind of fade on or fade off gives it a little extra kick and makes people notice the effect more. Before making this video, I did do some research to see if other people had tried this effect, and I saw similar techniques being used for like a long exposure effect on car headlights, where people had used an effect called echo in After Effects and had duplicated the layers and used a darker color blend mode. But every time I did this, I ended up with a really choppy effect that just didn't look nearly as smooth as when using this technique, which looks pretty much just like an authentic long exposure photo because you're taking 100 frames and blending them together. So it's basically a 4 second exposure. Another element I like to add to this effect is to have a subject in the frame that doesn't have the long exposure effect on it or is even moving in slow motion to just suspend reality even more with this effect. To do that, I had to shoot an additional clip while my camera was still on the tripod in that exact same position. I just had my boy Tommy walk into the frame and I filmed that at 60 frames per second. Then in post, I slowed that down and basically just masked him out and superimposed that layer over the original shot. And since they're both shot from that tripod angle, then it lines up perfectly. Since we're masking that subject out, it's also really important when shooting that you make sure they're not passing in front of the part of the frame that you want that long exposure effect on. If he were to pass directly in front of the water, I would have to really meticulously cut him out in front of it, whereas we shot it in such a way that he doesn't do that, so I can just draw a general mask around him and it gets the job done. And finally, now that we've gone through the authentic technique for creating this effect, let's talk about a quick shortcut you can possibly use to pull off something similar in some cases, and that's RSMB. RSMB, or Real Smart Motion Blur, is a plugin for Adobe that basically just allows you to create realistic fake motion blur in your footage. It's great for like hyperlapses or a shot that you shot in slow motion and then want to speed back up and have realistic motion blur on. When you're using RSMB, it's almost always the best practice to set the amount of motion blur to 0.5 or 50%. This way it's adding a realistic amount of motion blur in alignance with that 180 degree shutter rule. But if you want to get a little crazy with it and turn that amount up to maybe 5 or 10, then it starts to add more than 1 second's worth of motion blur. So in some cases, I've basically just put RSMB on the clip and turned the motion blur effect up to like 5 or 10, and I get a similar effect. RSMB is the technique I would use if I wanted a more subtle effect, whereas I would always make sure to use the After Effects technique, blending all those separate layers together for a more dramatic effect where I want everything to really be silky and smoothed out. But I hope you've enjoyed this video, learned something new from it. If you haven't seen the original video this technique was used in, it's probably my favorite video I've ever made. It came out like last week, so click right up here to check that out. I don't think you'll regret it. But that's all for now. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next video.